There's a lot that goes into being a police officer and patrolling the roads and responding to various calls across the community. I had the opportunity to do a ride-along with the Howell Police Department and speak to them about some of those responsibilities and things that you need to know while you're on the road as well.
How you doing, ma'am? How can I police? Do you have your license registration insurance on you?
Police officers have eyes and ears on the road with a sharp attention to detail of what's going on and where. If there's an issue that needs to be addressed and corrected, the officer will speak to the driver or individual involved and take additional action if and when needed.
We always maintain a high sense of visibility. We believe that there's some type of tangible benefit to that, whether it's just in a diversionary effect for criminal elements, but also for, the safety of the community. So they feel when they see us that they feel a certain sense of security.
In less than a second and without hesitation, an officer could get a call coming in over the radio to head to a certain destination for any number of scenarios, so they have to be able to drive to that given location for the reasons given and be able to mentally, emotionally, and physically prepare for what may and what will lie ahead once on a given scene. Multitasking and quick reaction by police is key for them, and letting them through on the roads, whether that's pulling over to let an officer pass or just not running a light or causing any kind of danger, is key for you.
They're driving a vehicle with emergency lights and sirens. People, unfortunately, do not yield the right of way as they should all the time. So there are several different things that they're handling all in one time. So multitasking is key. So again, the average patrol officer, and I use that term cautiously, has to do a lot in the time frame that somebody would, even have a hard time doing one task. So they're tasked with a lot, and that's what we hope that people realize, to yield the right of way in a safe manner to let us get to where we're going.
You could get pulled over driving your car for any number of reasons or motor vehicle violations, many of them small in nature, but you'll always get an explanation as to why you were stopped and what you have to do to address an issue. Nobody hits the open road hoping or looking to be pulled over and are usually disappointed or upset that they have been for whatever reason is then given by the officer. It's natural to feel that way, but respect and courtesy given by the officer and the driver go a long way, making it a peaceful and educational motor vehicle stop.
You want to get respect, but you want to give respect at the same time. So being compliant in the fact that even if you disagree with maybe the reason why you're pulled over or any issuance of a summons, whatever the case may be, we don't like to engage in any type of what we call, roadside courthouse. It's just not the appropriate time. It's unsafe and it's just not prudent. Now, it's not saying that we can't explain violations. We're not saying that we can't explain, an infraction, an equipment violation, or however may be the circumstance. But we just don't feel that, for a lot of different reasons, safety being paramount of both the officer and the occupants of the vehicle, that the roadside's the place to do that.
Police always hope for a courteous and respectful back and forth dialogue at a motor vehicle stop.
People aren't happy to be pulled over. We understand that. We take the human side of that as a big part of what we do.
In most cases, when you're pulled over, it'll be a simple conversation out of the window. But in some instances, when warranted, you may be asked to step out of the vehicle, which is a legal and reasonable request.
In the state of New Jersey, asking a driver of a motor vehicle out of the vehicle for any reason is perfectly constitutional and justifiable for a police officer to do. And again, there's ways to do it. We very rarely, unless it's a heightened situation, we very rarely are sitting there doing that under real tense circumstances. Normally, it's a very courteous interaction of, excuse me, would you mind stepping out of the vehicle so I could speak with you back here? And again, that's a constitutional, justification that we have to do.
For whatever reason you're pulled over, there are certain behaviors to adhere to and some to avoid to ensure things go smoothly all the way around, starting with communication and respect on both sides. And it's natural to feel nervous or panic in a seemingly tension-filled moment because you may feel you're in trouble, and police understand that and want to help keep things as calm as possible.
Polite and courteous is always the way to go, both on our behalf and on the behalf of an occupant of a motor vehicle. But, we'll direct them. A lot of people nowadays are getting a lot more educated, and better education means better interactions, right? So they'll ask us, hey, would you mind if I reach for my glove box? I'll get my driver's license, I'll get my registration and insurance. That's great. When people give us that type of courtesy, we give it right back.
Whether it's a verbal warning, a written warning, or a ticket in most cases after being pulled over, when it's over, you can take a deep breath and feel better knowing that both sides provided equal amounts of respect and courtesy. One driver who was pulled over on the ride-along I was on and let off with a verbal warning by Officer Kubiel certainly felt better about the way things went with both those things, plus a casual conversation to ease any tension.
He was very professional. and he handled it very well. He just explained to me that the registration was expired on the car, and it's not my car, so I didn't know, and I think it was very respectful and professional, and I appreciate him.
She was nervous for being pulled over, but the course of the conversation and how it went made it easier on her.
I'm always nervous, just because I don't want to burden them in any way, and I don't want my day to be burdened either. But he was very nice and he was very professional, so I appreciate it a lot.
In certain occasions, once the reason for the stop has been explained and everything checked out, those everyday casual conversations can take place.
A lot of the times, because we have such close ties to our community, we'll engage in conversation that is somewhat, you know, opposite and outside of motor vehicle enforcement. We have a very low percentage of our stops that actually result in the issuance of a citation or a formal summons, even of a formal written warning. The majority of our stops actually result in a verbal warning, and the fact that we did our job by pulling the person over. What we're primarily focused on here is obviously the safe travel and traversing of our roadways, but also the apprehension of the criminal element. We don't want that here. We don't tolerate that here. We feel our residents deserve better.
Both verbal and nonverbal communication are important in a police officer's job, and their commitment to their community and keeping everybody safe, happy, and healthy. One of the things I saw on the ride along today was a family walking by one of the traffic stops and two little kids just smiling at the officer and waving hello. No words said, none were needed, just a smile. In Howell, Vin Avenue, Town Square Media News.